The Compassion Project in Appleton is a project the Trout Museum did with Appleton Area School Districts. Every student in the school district was given a 6x6 inch tile and asked to depict compassion. Tim Riley, a Lawrence graduate and executive director of the Trout Museum, contacted President Jill Beck and asked her if Lawrence would somehow be involved in the Compassion Project. She asked me, and I said, sort of flippantly, absolutely, I'll do something. Didn't know it was going to be manhole covers, but we'll do something. This is a project that my intermediate and advanced sculpture students participated in. I literally gave them the prompt. What does compassion look like? How would you depict compassion? What does it mean to you? We did some readings about what compassion is, what it means.
I'm Ellie Crean. I'm a senior. And I'm an art history major, French minor. Coming into the Compassion Project, it was super awesome and exciting that we were doing manhole covers, but none of us were quite sure what to do visually for that. And we're all like, I have no idea what to do for that.
We took these dense foam blanks that the Neenah Foundry had given us, and my students and I carved our images in those blanks. But I wanted them to have a little bit of experience modeling relief sculpture, thinking about how one depicts imagery on that kind of low surface, flat plane.
I ended up using, because I'm an art history major, I was thinking about my favorite artist, who is Kandinsky. So I took a lot of shapes Kandinsky uses in his work, so everything is kind of going up and to the left because that's kind of moving in a positive direction.
Since I came to Lawrence, I've known about the Neenah Foundry, the world-famous Neenah Foundry, and we were fortunate enough to have the opportunity to actually go to the foundry and watch the entire process start to finish. So we gave them the blanks that my students and I had carved. They put them in a larger pattern. The foundry made molds and then cast molten iron in the molds.
It was fantastic to go and actually see them put our thing in and have the molds, and it was awesome. I had no idea what all went into making a manhole cover or any of the other things that they make.
Neenah Foundry, and we didn't know they were going to do this, but they ended up making three complete sets of the manhole covers. So one set was installed along College Avenue, and there's a couple here on campus. Another set we're giving to the students, and then a third set is going to be exhibited at the Campus Center Gallery this summer.
I think it's absolutely fantastic where mine is. Mine is out in front of the Dirty Leprechaun, which I'm very, very Irish, so I thought that was pretty awesome and very fitting.